Nobody plays finer than McCoy Tyner. Das ist so eine Redensart. Aber da ist was dran. Seit seiner Zeit mit John Coltrane gehört der Pianist zu den großen Persönlichkeiten des zeitgenössischen Jazz. Tyner hat die gesicherten Fundamente des akustischen Ensemblespiels nie verlassen. Die elektronische Moderne ist ihm fremd geblieben. Mit Freddie Hubbard verbindet ihn die Hingabe zu einem modern interpretierten Traditionalismus. Das McCoy-Tyner-Trio mit Freddie Hubbard und Ralph Moore auf dem Stuttgarter Jazzgipfel 1990.
To talk about John Coltrane, for me, as somebody of the young generation, you know, it's very interesting how important his work was, especially for you. Maybe you can explain a little bit about your work together with John Coltrane, also for the young audience, which is watching us probably also.
Well, I met John when I was 17. That's the first time I played with him, actually, before he formed the quartet. And he was with, then he went back with Miles Davis. He was with Miles in the early 50s, and and he came back to Philadelphia, and that's when I met him. And then he rejoined Miles, and they recorded so much great music. And then he told me he was going to form the quartet. And so I was with the Jazz Tet for about 6 months, another group of Benny Golson, who's also from Philly. And I left them and then joined John, you know, and around 1960, something like that. And from then on, it was just it was fantastic for me. It was like going to school, you know. It really was. It was just to get a chance to play that kind of music every night was just because he allowed me to develop. That's very important, and in an art form, to have the opportunity to grow. Yeah.
So it was a very personal inspiration for you.
Very, very much so. Yeah, yeah. It was very, very much so. I used to listen to him every night, and it was like in awe of the things, you know, the way he developed the music and his dedication and all those things I learned. So he was like a teacher, you know.
Yesterday, Branford Marsalis was here, and he said, tomorrow there will be McCoy Tyne and Freddie Hubbard, and there will the saxophone player Ralph Moore will be here. He said, he's going to play in here. Oh, I better have to leave because he's playing so good. I don't want to see him. Where did you find Ralph?
Well, I was really up. He's really coming up and coming. Really, really, he's going to be. I think he's going to be one of the giants of saxophone. He's really impressive. He has his own sound and approach. Yeah, I really like him. It's nice to see somebody young coming up that has their own direction and nice sound. He's a very nice young man.
Somebody behind the camera told me, I just looked at an old photo of John Coltrane, and he looks so similar, Ralph.
Yeah, that's true. There is some similarity. Yeah. Yeah, and then the whole demeanor, the whole feeling, you know. Yeah, it's a lot to him. Yeah.
You've been working very long together, Freddie and you. Can you tell us a little bit of the history of this work and of this cooperating together, Freddie Hubbard and McCoy Tyne?
Yeah, well, actually, Freddie has his own band, you know, and but we do pair up a lot of times, and I think he's such a tremendous musician. I mean, we kind of came up together in New York, and we became very good friends, and we did some recording together, a lot of recording together. So there's a, you know, he's over there.
Maybe he should join us. Freddie, why don't you come over? We talk about you. Maybe you should come on this side. It's better for the camera, better for the light.
Hey, this is my better side.
Is it better side?
Hey, look, wait a minute. What about the shadows? No shadows now.
You can watch in the monitor.
No.
It's okay?
Well, I don't care about that.
Yeah? Freddie, do you remember when you played the first time together with him? Do you still remember?
He made my first album with me on Blue Note, an album called Open Sesame. I was about 22 years old. And he came in, and he was a tremendous help in helping me get this record date together. And the record sold, and I became a kind of a star. So whenever I play the piano, I think of him. You know?
Yeah?
Yeah, because like I used to work with Herbie Hancock a lot, and then I would go play with McCoy, and the difference in the styles, McCoy I like because he's a little more natural. I like Herbie because he can play synthesizers and all that, but when it comes to the natural thing, McCoy is my man.
So many people just complain about the pop music and say it's too simple. And in the 70s, I have a few records, Freddie Hubbard, yeah?
No.
No? Which is so different.
No, you know, the record company, they didn't force me, but they said that if you do something commercial, then you'll get more fans. And me, like a dummy, I went for it. But
where are the fans?
I mean, I made some money. I made enough money to buy a house, you know, Mercedes. I got a couple of stocks. But that's over now. I'm ready to just play my instrument. And I think all the kids, the younger trumpet players, if you hear them, they're trying to play like Freddie Hubbard. Because I'm really back to the basics, and I'm really trying to stay an innovative trumpeter rather than just playing hot licks, you know.
He's always been an influence, you know, a major influence on trumpet in this music, as far as I'm concerned. You know. So
that's what you're looking for in the next year, just to work on this and continue on this.
Well, what I like to do is do some things with big bands, like he's been doing. Because that's the thrill. You know, like Dizzy, he's over it with a big band. And I would like to experience that before I, you know, slow down.
Don't slow down.
No, I mean, look, you know, like, you don't realize, since I moved to California, you know, you move out there with the palm trees and the swimming pools, and then you all of a sudden, I gotta go back to work and play with this guy. I mean, it takes a lot of energy to play with McCoy Tyner. I don't know if people realize that, but when you play with this guy, it's like you're playing with you're playing with three piano players at once. I mean, it's unreal.
See, I'm from New York. I live in New York City, so maybe that's what it is.
No, I live.
No, I have an idea.
I live right
Freddie,
around.
Freddie, did you ever do an interview with him in your home?
No, you do it.
No, you got 4 minutes now. This is the premiere. Yeah. Okay. Kept sitting.
Okay. Right. McCoy Tyner.
Go ahead. First.
Where do you see the jazz music going?
That's a hard question. I tried to answer, but it's difficult. Yeah, I don't know.
You know what? As I've been listening to a lot of the younger cats, what I do appreciate about them is that they're keeping the music going anyway.
Yeah,
they're playing straight jazz, and they're not jumping off into the commercial stuff before they learn the instruments.
Yeah, I think it's important. I think you and I have, you know, we've hung in there and done a lot of things musically. If we do something, you know, sort of different, that's great. I think it's good for them to sort of do their apprenticeship and learn the art, and you know, and then, you know, maybe they want to do some different things. I mean, no one is restricting them, say they have to do this or they have to do that, but I think at some point, if they want to deal with this music, it's like you learn the repertoire. Mm-hmm. You know,
but I think that we both have been fortunate. Like you played with Train, I played with Blakey, and that was an experience that I will never.
It's like going to school.
Yeah, you know, it's an education.
It's an education.
Know.
You need that. I mean, in whatever profession you're in,
I think that playing with a big band like you're doing now, I had the chance to play with Quincy Jones, and
that must have been great because Quincy's a great arranger.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, fantastic. You know.
So what's next?
You were perfect. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you so much, both of you.
Thank you very much.
Yeah?
Thanks a lot.
It was a great interview, Freddie.
Thank you.
I like it so much.
You did a good job.
Yeah, you got a new job, yeah? Thank you.